Education is the passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. Welcome back to our channel. Please subscribe to Easy Dentistry. If you have not yet done, let us know your feedback in the comment box. And most important of all, don't forget to share these lectures with your friends. This lecture is on an important topic, that is osteoid osteoma. The osteoid osteoma is a benign tumor of bone which has seldom been described in the jaws. It was first described by Jaffe and Lichtenstein as a true neoplasm of osteoblastic derivation. Trauma and inflammation are primary cause of osteoid osteoma. Clinical features, it mostly occurs in young persons less than 30 years of age. The male to female ratio is 2:1 and it occurs mostly in the long bones, namely femur and tibia. Pain is a consistent feature associated with osteoid osteoma. Pain is very sharp and it is worst at night. Oral manifestation, mandible is affected more than the maxilla. The body of mandible, condyle and the maxillary antrum are the common sites of occurrence. Now here in this picture you can see osteoid osteoma in the body of mandible of this patient. Radiographic features, it appears as ovoid to round radiolucent area less than 1 cm in diameter with a rim of sclerotic bone having foci of calcification and new periosteal bone formation. So here you can see a radiographic picture of osteoid osteoma. Histologic features, there is a central nidus of compact osteoid tissue with varying calcification and vascular connective tissue. Osteoclasts are seen with foci of bone resorption. Periosteum shows new bone formation. So here you can see osteoid tissue in the stroma with fibrovascular connective tissue stroma. And these bone tissue is mature. Treatment is surgical removal. Recurrence rate is low. And the lesion may spontaneously regress if not treated. Next lecture will be on benign osteoblastoma. That's all for now. Happy studying.